Alright, what's going on guys? Fortminor back at it again in here for another video for you guys for today. And today I am in here for a different kind of video, and in a way a video response to the Lex Man and the video that he did. And that's pretty much a fantasy rebooking on the Divas division. You know, I've been wanting to do this for a while. I know I was supposed to come in here during my ROH review, but I wasn't really able to watch that. I didn't realize what time the show actually started, which was around, you know, 4 o'clock as of yesterday. So I was going to do a rare review. I might still do that, you know, if I can watch a replay of it. So sometime during the week, I might actually get to do the ROH review. But I am in here for a fantasy booking on, you know, rebooking the Divas and how, you know, I would rebook it to make it more interesting and so people can be more interested in it and, you know, to at least make it somewhat of a strong division. And let's face it, as of late, you know, the Divas division hasn't really been what it used to be, you know, in the good old days. So, you know, since, you know, the greats have left, like Trish Stratus, Lita, you know, Victoria, Mickey, and all of them have left. And now going into nowadays, you know, with the Divas, haven't really been, you know, haven't gotten that proper time to be noticed. You know, especially, you know, with the time in their matches and stuff like that, I will be getting into. So, this won't be, you know, that long of a video, but, you know, I am gonna run, you know, some things down, you know, getting into this. So, you know, with that being said, and speaking of time, like I mentioned, you know, with the time, you know, with their matches, they haven't, you know, been given the proper time. Whether it's been like a 5 minute or less match, you know, really isn't that much time to have, you know, to have them get noticed. So with that being said, I would give them enough time, maybe at least 10 to a little bit more than that, to get people, you know, into the match and so they can enjoy it a little bit more and the Divas can, you know, pull off some, you know, different moves and, you know, get the fans excited. So that's pretty much one of the major problems right now is with the time. So that's one of the major things I would fix, you know, with the Divas. Next thing I would add, you know, as well, you know, bringing in more Divas. Kind of keeping it, you know, to the same point, you know, the same amount of guys that are in, you know, with their division and everything like that, you know, kind of keeping it the same, you know, bringing more ideas in so we can have more feuds and we can get, you know, more women interested as well. So keep bringing in some more, you know, female wrestlers, probably from, you know, FCW, probably bringing, you know, Eddie Guerrero's daughter in as well, probably bring back Serena since we didn't really get to see her wrestle that much at all since, you know, she was a manager for, you know, CM Punk, so I would bring her in and, you know, she'll work a couple of good matches, you know, with some of the women's wrestlers. So I think that would be, you know, definitely cool to have, you know, just bring in some new ones and maybe even some veterans as well to put over, you know, some of the women's wrestlers that are coming on in or, you know, just to work some feuds and have, you know, that, you know, one more match. Pretty much, so I think that would be pretty interesting. Championships, I would definitely bring back the Women's Championship. You know, to me, that should have never ended. And the way how they, you know, just split up that whole title with Lay Cole just, you know, really pissed me off because that was, you know, a good title. It was the Women's Championship, and, you know, it actually meant some, but, you know, towards, you know, you know, last year and everything like that, you know, I didn't like how it really ended. It should have never ended, but I will bring it back so, you know, the women's wrestlers can have something to fight for, have it more prestigious. Now, with the Divas Championship, I will probably keep that, you know, kind of like a mid-card championship. That would be something new. I think that would be pretty interesting to have, but it definitely won't look like it, how it is now. It would look like somewhat similar to the Women's Championship and that, you know, actually look like a title that, you know, the girls will want to fight for and stuff like that. So, like I said, probably like a mid-card championship, a step up to the Women's Championship and, you know, again, have something to fight for. So that would be something interesting to see and to have with that. You know, some of the, you know, people I will have in here, like I mentioned, Eddie Guerrero's daughter, I would have Serena, Melina, Gail Kim, Natalia, Karma, Definitely some of the, women's wrestlers that we have that are already on the roster. Alicia Fox, Beth Phoenix, Tamina, AJ, Caitlyn, some of the, the newer divas I will definitely have as well. They would definitely get to be in there. Some of the potential feuds that I have in this, with the division and everything, definitely the Gail Kim and Melina feud has been on Superstars 2 as of late, and as well as Twitter. Melina saying that, as of late, Gail Kim was her best friend, and, they're fighting over that pretty much. I definitely would bring that onto TV and as well as on pay-per-view, just to get their feud officially underway and, have some matches with them. Probably even for the Women's Championship too down the road as well. And, probably have them, get over that and, to see how they would coexist and eventually, be friends probably, if not, I'll probably, have him still in the feud, but, depending on what's going to happen with that, but I will have him start off, to have the feud get underway. I will have something in store for Karma as well. She can definitely work a feud with, Beth Phoenix to see who is the, true dominant, diva in the division, have a couple of matches with her, even with the, championship too, probably, and as well, after that, working, match with Natalia, and so on and so forth. So, she will be coming back as that dominant heel, now that she, is supposed to be pregnant. So once she comes back, that's probably what I would do, and, have it be that dominant heel that everyone would be interested in, and, in a way, kind of undefeated, but, not for too long. Anyway, that's what I'll probably do. There's, a couple other feuds that will happen, down the road. Definitely I will probably have, that Gail Kim and Karma feud, officially be, debuting, if you will, into, the WWE. And, that would definitely be something interesting and something that I want, to see and been wanting to see for quite some time. So definitely I will have that feud, get underway as well. That's just, some of the feuds that I will be having, some of the potential feuds and stuff like that. But that's pretty much it as of right now. There are some other things, that can be definitely done, with the Divas Division, but that is just some of the things to, just to, plan out and, I think, that would help out too. So, everyone can get interested and, not, fall asleep or anything like that or take piss breaks because, like I said, let's face it, the Divas Division isn't really what it used to be. And yes, I pretty much am a fan of women's wrestling. So, if we can have those couple of things, I think, to me, it would help out and people will say, different things than what they're saying, and I have a different opinion on it, and I probably will be more into it. So, that's just, a couple of things, I would help out with. So, let me know what you guys' thoughts are. Definitely, if you guys feel like it, leave a video response. I'd love to hear you guys' thoughts and opinions. Continue the discussion down below there in the comment box down below. Let me know what you guys liked about it, what you didn't like, what you guys could, done differently. Of course, you can definitely leave your thoughts, but that about does it pretty much for this video, and as always, I will talk to you guys later on. Peace.